Yeah, not the result. Too many self-inflicted stuff, especially in that third quarter. And when you play a good team like UNLV, that makes it tough to recover. Like the way they battle, never have a question about that, but we got to eliminate the self-inflicted things that are costing us the last couple weeks.
Question for Coach?
Trent, what did you see from your offense in the second half that just wasn't working?
I think it's that. It was, we turned the ball over down there, gave them the ball in scoring position. Just didn't protect like we normally protect, took sacks. Just stuff that shouldn't have happened that we could have control over.
You didn't see UNLV doing anything differently?
Well, they're good. I mean, their pass rushers just got home. And that's, we got to be on our work all the time against a good team. We can't have those lapses, and that's what it was.
Coach, this makes three straight weeks now that you guys have blown a first half lead. How much is that a concern moving forward for the rest of the season?
You never want to blow a lead. I mean, college football, it's going to go back and forth. You're in close games, so leads are going to change when you're in close games. We just got to make sure we stay on course, which we got off course.
I know there were still some positives. The secondary at least caught my eye. I thought they did a really good job tonight holding UNLV in the passing game. Can you just speak about how some of the players have stepped up through the injuries tonight?
Yeah, I thought there was a lot of good plays in the back end. I'm Exodus Ayers, who true freshman who hasn't played a ton all year, stepped up and made some plays in the second half. Andre Jordan continues to make plays, which is great. So there are guys that are continuing to improve.
Coach, how big of a swing did you feel like that block punt at the end of the second quarter turned the momentum into their favor?
Yeah, I mean, it was a end of half, giving them an opportunity to get a field goal and score three. Instead of going up four, you're only up one at halftime. Wasn't good. Now I did like the way we they got the ball too, but we were able to get a stop and keep them out from truly capitalizing on that middle eight. But that hurt.
What did you make of Giovanni's play? Sort of, again, giving you guys a chance in the end there, driving down the field.
Yeah, I mean, he made the throws we need him to make. We moved the ball down the field, and we just ran out of time.
After last week at Nevada, what caught your eye about the run defense today?
I thought they were definitely more sound. They're still, we got to continue to get better, but I thought there was improvement in that area, which was good to see, and we got to keep growing that way.
Trent, with 2 minutes to go, you had scored. How much thought did you give to trying an onside kick at that point?
We thought about it, but with the warning still and having all three, we had four timeouts. So we felt good about kicking it to them and getting the ball back.
Did you get a good look at that last play of the game?
I have not. I wanted to and before I came in here, but it's probably best I didn't, I'm going to guess.
You guys fought back. You had a chance there in the end, but now it's two losses in a row. What do you got to tell your team, to keep this from snowballing?
It's just we got to learn and grow from each win and loss. There was a lot of growth, I thought, from last week. We played a really good UNLV team, but there's things we got to learn from because we could have controlled some of the stuff that went wrong tonight ourselves. And so those are the things we got to take care of. Is the things we can control of, then we got to take care of those things. All right.